To see how to use, find the MediaPipe record component in the MediaPipe4U DVH plugin and drag it into the scene. Here are some DVH related parameters, such as frame rate, whether to automatically stop recording when MediaPipe stops capturing, etc. In the blueprint of the demo project, I have written how to control the BV recorder. You can download the blueprint to the GitHub to view the demo project. Here I add my recorder to the blueprint variable. I also did a simple UI in the demo project, check record BVH and other operations are the same as MediaPipe4U motion capture. When you stop motion capture, you will be prompted to select a file to save BVH data. Open this file and you can see that BVH data has been generated. Now, let's use Blender to import this BVH file. Select the BVH file generated in Blender. The rotation and forward axis have been converted to the standard BVH format. You do not need to change these options. Just click Import. Now, we can see that the skeleton, but Blender does not use the frame rate in BVH file. Let's adjust it manually. Let me see the frames. Play animation. Let's go back to UI editor. Let me demonstrate one of the property use root bone. When you enable use root bone, the first bone in the model will be used as the root bone. If you do not enable it, the pairwise mapped in MediaPipe4U will be used as the root bone. Let's take a look at the skeleton changes after enabling the root bone. Export BVH after recording an animation. Import in Blender. As you see, the root bone of the Unreal Engine model is also included in the skeleton, which will be helpful for people who need to make root motion. Thanks for watching.